Hello and welcome to the garage. In this video today I will be talking about a battery. Battery is probably the most important and most valuable part of any EV conversion, simply because it's probably the heaviest, it's probably the most expensive part. And now with my DC to DC converter saga finished, I can really focus on the battery and start looking at various options I could consider for purchasing the battery part. Hello, I'm Ed, and I'm building an electric car conversion. I've spent a few weeks working on the Toyota Prius inverter and the open inverter board. The challenge I set myself is to build an electric car conversion on the budget. Therefore, I was choosing components for my project very carefully. Now that I have a motor spinning in the sine mode and performed an FOC tuning, having figured out how to get DC to DC converter working, I can now move to choosing the battery. OEM manufacturers are building battery packs using different cell form factors. Main form factors we can define as cylindrical, that is what's used by Tesla, pouch cells used by Nissan Leaf and Chevrolet Bolt, and prismatic cells used by BMW, Mercedes and Volkswagen. If I consider Tesla modules, the best ones would be from Model S or Model X. Model 3 modules are very tightly integrated, they're glued in within the module itself, and it probably will be quite hard to position such a long module in EV conversion. And taking module apart is practically impossible, I think. So the best option would be to go for something like this module there. So one of the issues there is not that many modules actually available in the UK. And the ones that are available, they're in high demand. The other option would be to look at Nissan Leaf modules. In this case, we have 8 modules, 1.7 kilowatt hours, which is selling for £700. One of the best options I find are BMW hybrid modules, where we're getting roughly 12 kilowatt hours for £1,000. Another interesting option are the cattle batteries available for sale on Alibaba. So we have two configurations there. One is 4S1P, which gives you about 14 volts. And another option is a slightly different model with 22.2 volts, 6S1P. So the prices are around about 220 to 60. So basically, what I've done, I've collated all the information for these modules and compared them with the modules as are available on eBay. Having combined together all the modules and calculating the price for each of the modules separately and calculating the price pounds per kilowatt hours, it actually turns out that the best options would be either BMW pack or cattle batteries. And actually cattle batteries are a bit cheaper, but these prices calculated excluding shipping. I guess if we add shipping, it will probably turn out that cattle will probably be more expensive and we'll have to wait more. At the same time, the downside of BMW packs is that these come out from a used car and cattle is supposed to be new, but at the same time I guess most of the cattle stuff sold on Alibaba would be something that didn't pass quality control at the cattle factory itself, and they probably won't be at best quality. Until you test one, I don't think it would be possible to actually say for sure whether it's gonna be a good module or bad module. So yeah, lots of thinking to be done and decide which way to go.
I feel that choosing the right battery module would be a rather tricky process, as this can have lots of pitfalls in the way that you can choose a bad module if you buy a second-hand one, or ordering from Alibaba from China could be quite a lengthy delivery, as well as you may also get not very good quality module. Anyway, I think I'm gonna try and research some more supplier options and see what's available out there. If you have had a similar experience, please let me know in descriptions below. And if you wanted to watch some of the previous episodes for my EV conversion, you can have a look at video over there or the one over there. And I will see you in the next video.